Hi everyone. Thanks very much for coming. My name's Jon Delaney, and coming through there. Testing, testing.
Lovely.
All right, I'm not going to bore you with any details yet. We're very happy to be here. I'm very happy to be playing with these guys. And let's just start with the music. I'll talk later when it strikes me. The first tune we're going to play is a tune by a guy called Sarane Ferret, who was a guitarist, a contemporary of Django Reinhardt's, in sort of 1930s and 40s Paris. He ran his own quintet, which was pretty much an exact copy of Django's quintet of the Hot Club of France, and Sarane Ferret ran this one as well. It had sort of a little bit more of a sort of dark Europe gypsy feeling to it, with a very different violinist than I don't know if you guys know Stefan Grappelli, sort of famously played with Django. Sarane Ferret's violinist had a much more sort of deep European bent, and he wrote some fantastic, simple but very sort of very singable tunes. One of which we'll play for you now. It's entitled Swing Star.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, guys. The next tune we're going to play is, I guess you could say, it's sort of Django Reinhardt's theme song. It's named after him, and it's entitled Djangology. I think it's a Grappelli composition. I'm not entirely sure.
Thank you.
All right, guys. This is we're going to play now the first waltz for the night. There's quite a tradition of gypsy and music and musette waltzes from the from late 20s. They used to play these in all the dance halls. The original instrumentation was the musette, which is a type of sort of bagpipe, which was later. That role was later taken over by the accordion. There were these, it's an interesting story, there were these two rival families, and one of them played the musette, which was the old sort of, you know, on the way out, and the other family specialized in the accordion, and the two sort of heads of the family were, the father-in-law was the musette player, and his daughter's friend was an accordion player, and there was almost like a medieval joining of the families when they married, and they solved all of their differences and stopped their rivalry. And eventually, the musette was pretty much replaced completely by the accordion system music. There's a really rich tradition of these waltzes, and a lot of them you learn to play them on guitar to improve your technique, and a lot of them are really hard, but they're really beautiful and lovely. So we're going to play the first one for you. Is it Tony Moreno?
This is a
waltz by an accordion player called Tony Moreno, and it's called Passion, and it's great. Nick Haywood on the double bass. and Josh Dunn on rhythm guitar. Josh is actually a great soloist as well. We'll be giving him some a couple of features throughout the night to show off what he can do. All right, this is another Sarane Ferret tune. This one's an absolute corker. It's a slow march sort of a tune. I have no idea why, but it's entitled Royal Blue, and this is just a great tune. I hope you all enjoy it. Danny's going to start with a big intro.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I think it's come time for Josh's feature. So,
what are we doing?
Great. Josh is going to play a tune for us now. It's entitled Hungaria. It's a very commonly played tune in this repertoire, and it's a real cracker. Josh, take it away. It's by Lulu Reinhardt. It's entitled Lulu Swing. And me and Danny are going to play it. Ready?
Why not?
Australian? Or? She kind of sings like that.
What? Change the mood a little bit now and play a bolero, Gypsy style. We're going to play a bolero. This one's a Django Reinhardt composition. It's entitled True Blind Bolero, and it has an intro that I haven't told Nick about.
That's exciting.
Fingers along. you all very much. We're going to excuse Danny again. And we're going to play another waltz. This waltz is... this one's entitled Le Vals des Niglos, which is the Waltz of the Hedgehogs. I like to think sort of part of this tune sounds a little bit... there's a major section which sounds a little bit sort of life-affirming, but the section that it starts with is in a minor key and is sort of a little bit dark. And it's called the Waltz of the Hedgehogs, and the hedgehogs are reportedly a delicacy in some of the sort of darker parts of Europe. So I like to think of this being maybe the final waltz of the hedgehogs. Changes for soloing. Welcome Danny back to the stage. This is called Swing de Paris. It's another hot Club de France number. It's a Django Reinhardt, Stefan Rebelli composition. Four times.
Thank you.
thank you very much. We're going to do now, this is in Django's lifetime, this was his most famous song. This is a very interesting song. It was, he wrote it in the late 30s, and during the war in Paris, when the Nazis banned the Marseillaise because it was rallying the resistance a little bit too much, this became the de facto national anthem of France, and it made Django a lot of money in the meantime and allowed him to retire early. It's called Nuage, which means clouds, and we are going to play it with its original intro, originally played with the two clarinet lineup that Django had running for pretty much most of his recording career. There's a, everyone sort of knows about the band with Stefan Grappelli, but the majority of Django's recorded output was recorded with clarinet players like Hubert Rostang, who played the clarinet, I think, on the original version of this. It's a beautiful song. We're gonna play it for you.
Thank you.
so much, everyone, and thanks everyone to coming. For coming. It's really great to see so many people here. It's really fantastic. We're going to play one more tune for this set, and then we're going to take a break for a little bit and come back. Well, that was the PA. This tune is one of the more obscure Django Reinhardt compositions. This is called Place de Brouckère. It's I think it's a square in Belgium. Django was originally born in Belgium before moving to France, and it's a blues with a few little interesting bits, which you will hear. Cool.
Four in the solos.
Yeah.
The times in which I did today's trophy is 5-4 to 2.
Yeah.
Cool.
I'm going to do glasses.
Just that would be better. That's 8.
3-3-5.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep. All right. Place de Brouckère.
Thank you.
thank you so much, everyone. We're going to take a break and come back. So far, you have been listening to Danny Healy on the clarinet. Nick Haywood on the double bass. Nick has some CDs for sale.
Yeah,
some recently released CDs of his band, which he would love you to come and talk to him about.
Got a quick little It's a quartet like this, but it's not Gypsy jazz. But in the true Gypsy tradition, I will take your money and never see you again.
And everyone, please, Josh Dunn on rhythm guitar. Yeah.
Jon Delaney, everyone. Yeah.
Thank you very much. We'll be back soon. Thank you. Thanks very much for sticking around, everyone, and for those who've just arrived, thank you for coming. We're going to kick off this set with one of the classic songs of Europe. This is Dark Eyes, Les Yeux Noirs. thanks very much, everyone. Dark Eyes. We're going to continue now with another tune by Sarane Ferret. If anyone wasn't here, this is Django Reinhardt's contemporary imitator. There's somewhere on the internet it describes Sarane Ferret. So Sarane Ferret was one of a number of brothers that all played in Django Reinhardt's rhythm section. And Sarane Ferret is described somewhere on the internet as a competent guitarist in the Manouche style, but lacking the necessary spark to attain greatness. What a way to be remembered. He did write some great tunes, and this one's called Miami. Yeah, it's a theme from Miami Vice.
I'm
next tune. This next tune is a beautiful ballad. There are a whole lot of ballads in the from the period sort of between the two world wars, and especially during World War II, where there are all of these great French ballads that basically talk about the loved one going away, and the implication is that they've gone away to possibly very bad things and might not be coming back. This one's called Je suis seul ce soir, I'm alone tonight.
Turn on the lights and we come out.
Thank you.
very much, everyone. We are going to continue now with Waltz. Danny can move it. All right. This next waltz that we're going to play is was originally written by a man that I had the good fortune to study with a few months ago in the Netherlands, a guitarist called Fappy Lapata. Fappy has been playing. Has been playing this music since the 70s and has sort of kept the flame alive during the 70s and 80s when there wasn't too much interest in the music. Check him out, he's on YouTube. This is a waltz written by him in honour of his uncle, Bubba Ferret, who was a great violinist and singer who passed away early last year, I think. And this is the waltz Fappy wrote for him. We're going to play it a bit faster and probably with a little bit more gusto than Fappy would appreciate. But he won't hear it. Two parts. There's a sad part and a happy part. It's tears of sadness, tears of joy. The answer's not what you think.
Happy with it. down in the gutter?
Thank you.
body that was tears of sadness, tears of joy. This next one is a Django Reinhardt blues. It's called Blues de Autrefois. I think it's like Blues of Yesterday or something like that. I think that's right. Here we go.
That should be right at the back.
Thanks everyone. We're going to feature our rhythm guitarist Josh Dunn on lead guitar again. And for Josh, everyone. Josh is going to play, it's another Django Reinhardt tune for everyone that was just waiting for that to happen. This one's called Webster and it's from. Yeah. And it's a theme from the TV show Webster. This is from a period when, somewhere in the late 40s, Django Reinhardt, who really wouldn't have approved of what we're doing now at all, decided that he'd had enough of the old style music that everybody really liked, and he was going to go and explore bebop and all these other things. And this is sort of from that period where he started playing more modern music, which wound up to him getting very upset that nobody was coming to his gigs anymore. But some of the modern stuff that he played is really fantastic and really really sort of something different for the time. He sort of created bebop out of his own head after a few listenings to things on the radio, and it came out different to the way everybody else played. Josh is going to play Webster, the theme from the TV show.
Thank you.
Another Django Reinhardt composition, Stomping a Decker. It's a quick one. This is This is written by Joseph Cosma. I don't know if any of you guys know that tune, Autumn Leaves, everybody knows. This is written by the same guy, and it's a great tune. There are about four chords in this tune, but it's just... They're all jams. D minor. Alright, this is called Clairvaux, Joseph Cosma. I'll play the first time when we play it.
It's
going
to be
good. Yeah.
Thank you.
I just like to say, next tune is called Indifference. It's a waltz. Kind of easy down.
Oh, it's a melody, sorry.
Nick Haywood on the double bass. And Josh Dunn on the rhythm guitar and the bass lick track. Okay, we're going to finish off with one last tune. This is the anthem of the Gypsy Jazz movement. We couldn't finish the Jazz Steps. We couldn't finish the gig without doing it. This is Django's probably most known and most played tune. This is the Minor Swing. Thanks so much for coming, everybody. We really appreciate it.
Jon Delaney on guitar, everybody.
What do you mean? Like, what? Two. Okay.